Hello, it's Karen with Xanadu Muse, and welcome to my channel. I just got back from Las Vegas, so this is going to be a souvenir haul. Besides the souvenirs that I picked up, I also took over 2,000 pictures and video. And no, I will not make you suffer through all 2,000 pictures and video. I am going to edit those and make another little video to highlight my vacation. But in the meantime, I want to share with you what I did bring back. So let's jump into that right away. Let's see where to start, Well, I have two dogs and two cats, so I had to ask somebody to watch them for me, and I got this cup for her. It's the Las Vegas coffee mug. And I actually got that at Walgreens for $7.99, I think. It was cheaper at Walgreens, oddly enough. I lost my lens cap, so I got another one of these. It was rather expensive, it was $15, and it turned out that I lost the filter right along with the lens cap, so I'm going to have to replace the filter. What else did I get while I was in Las Vegas and Grand Canyon and the Hoover Dam? M&M's. M&M World. Of course, we had to stop into the M&M World, and we bought a pound of M&M's, dark chocolate. And we snacked on that all week long while we were there. What else? Oh, this is an odd that these two next two things are odd things to haul as souvenirs, but I did buy them and I did get them. Well, I got these scissors at Walgreens. I collected a whole bunch of those brochures and you know whatnots, what to do. You know what I'm talking about. And I wanted to cut them up and put them in a scrapbook type, junk journal type thing. And I didn't bring scissors. So, I picked these up at Walgreens. I'm going to give them to my mom because she is a crocheter and she needs scissors. Me, I have 3 million pairs, so I do not need them. I'm going to let her have these. They were like $3.50 for three, so that's not a bad deal. I did want to also buy a box of envelopes. And they went at $5 at Walgreens for a box of envelopes. Well, we all know we can go to the Dollar Tree and get them for a dollar. So I said, no, thank you. I ended up finding a box of envelopes in the Grand Canyon at a food mart, food pantry, something like that. And it's these. I've used a few of them. And they were $1.89. That was a much better deal than $5. So, yes, I hauled that too. What else? Oh, yes, the pins. I took a few of the pins from the hotels we were at. When I do the video with the pictures and the other videos, I'm going to explain how the trip went. We flew into Las Vegas. We went to the Grand Canyon, and then we came back to Las Vegas. So we stayed in two different hotels in Las Vegas because of the pricing. And the first hotel we stayed at was the Mirage. And here is the Mirage pin. And then here is the hotel we stayed in. Well, I didn't pinch one. They give them to you free. I didn't get one at the Grand Canyon because it was a Days Inn. But I did pick up one at the Big E Steakhouse. That was where we ate our dinner the second night. And I did pick up a pin from Caesar Palace, which was across the street from the last hotel we were at, which was Bailey's. And I picked up two of those. So, those are some freebie things. And what else did I get? Oh, I got this Las Vegas mug. It's nothing glamorous. It was another Walgreens purchase. It was $4.95, I think. There's not a price tag on it. It was like a third of what most of the mugs were, so I picked that up. Then I picked, on our way to Grand Canyon, we went to the Hoover Dam. So I picked up this, and I did pay full price for this one, which was about $12. And you get the Hoover Dam and some antelope and whatever things you might find near the Hoover Dam. And then while I was at the Grand Canyon, of course I picked up a mug. This was the second one I had picked out. The first one, they let me exchange it for this one because it does have the year 2016 on it. And it says advice from a national park, Grand Canyon National Park. It says be ready for adventure, find beauty all around you, tread lightly on the earth, cherish wild spaces, spend time outdoors, keep a sense of wonder, take a hike. Okay, I will do all but take a hike. And since I was like in a deserty climate, is that a word? Desertery? I picked up some chapstick and it says Las Vegas. It was also at Walgreens for $1.99. And the next items, I don't think you're going to be able to see them. And I don't know if I even can take a picture to show them. But I picked up some pennies. Well, let's see. This one was Circus Circus. I don't know if you can see it. Can you see it? That one's Circus Circus. I'll try to take pictures. And this one is the Watchtower Grand Canyon. My uncle worked here. The whole point of the trip was to spread his ashes at the park. And if we weren't supposed to do that, well, it's too late. His ashes are spread. And this one, this is Berzonia. On the way back, there is a little park called Berzonia. Bears, because there's bears in the park. And it was like a zoo park. And Zonia as in Arizona, no, Zona as in Arizona, so it's Bearzona. And you can drive through and there's bears and there's wolves and there's bison and there's sheep and there's goats. And then you walk through and they had the most gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous jaguar, aka Black Panther, I have ever seen. I wanted to stay, but you know, we had to get back to Las Vegas and I will explain why a little bit later. And here's a Grand Canyon penny. I'll try to take pictures. And here's the Hoover Dam. And here's a Las Vegas penny. And let's see, this is another Las Vegas penny. I was going to get one of the M&M World, but it didn't say M&M World Las Vegas. So I was disappointed. Another Grand Canyon penny. I got yucky nails. This is Berzonia. I must have got two Berzonias. It's a bear. You can't really tell. So those are my pennies. What else did I get? I got two t-shirts. The first one was from Las Vegas. It's not exactly the one I wanted. I wanted the pink or the green, but they didn't have my size. So I got this one with the sign. And let's see, what else did I get? And I got this at the airport. My mother thought I was crazy for spending so much for it, but it's a Las Vegas coloring book. And I got it for several reasons, because our hotel was in there. Well, first of all, the sign. And let's see. There is some activities. It is more for our kids. There's the Paris Hotel, which we were supposed to stay at, but was changed. And this was Treasure Island Hotel. And there's some salamanders, I guess. Lizards, I don't know. And there's a Road Runner. And I think this is Excalibur. We did go hotel hopping. And we did go to the Excalibur. We went to all of these, actually. And this is the Bellagio. And I believe this is Caesar Palace. I think this is the Luxus or something. I can't remember the name of that one. We didn't go into that one. There's some of the wild animals in that indigenous to the area. There's a Hoover Dam. We did go see that. And there's the big Ferris wheel. They have one in Myrtle Beach and they have one in London. And you can, what is that thing across Las Vegas? I didn't actually see where it was, but there's some more the same pictures. There is the monorail. We never rode the monorail. We rode the bus. And there's Las Vegas Boulevard. And there's New York, New York. We did go into New York, New York for a second. And there's a helicopter ride over Las Vegas. And I know the Mirage is in here. Where's the Mirage? Here's the Mirage with the volcano. We saw that the last night. And I'm not sure which this one is. It might be Caesar Palace again. I don't know. And Circus. So I spent $6.95 for that. So it is kind of an expensive little book. And while I was at the Grand Canyon, I also bought another coloring book, but it was a little bit heftier. It's 59 Illustrated National Parks coloring books, so it's 59 pages, the posters of 59 of the parks. And I've been to a few of these parks, and I haven't been to a few of them, a lot of them. So yes, that was $19.95. Got that at Grand Canyon. Let's talk about some of the bags I got. Yeah, I told you I had picked up a lot of like little brochures and stuff, and I needed a bag to carry it in, so I bought this one. I paid way too much for this. It was $5.99. I think I got a better deal with the $6.95 coloring book than the $5.99 very thin, cheap little backpack. But it did what it was supposed to do, and it does say Las Vegas on there. Mom picked this up, and I ended up keeping it for myself, and it's this little duffel bag. With the yellow, and they had like green and pink, and I think they had another color, blue, and it has Las Vegas on it. And I use this as a camera bag for most of the time there, like all the way up to the last day, pretty much. And I'll show you what I switched to. Okay, and I got some postcards. Sticky, Las Vegas postcard. And here's another Las Vegas postcard. I paid $1 for this. I know. Crazy. I bought this book. And it's got these postcards on the back. I'm trying to get it in there. Whoops! New York, New York. And it's got a little side piece too. And another view. A big shot of Las Vegas. And here's Las Vegas Boulevard. We'll just take these out because I'm going to rip them up anyway. And here's Circus. I remember this when I was like 8 years old, 8 or 9 years old. I would lean over the banner and say, "Mom, stop gambling." And here's the flamingo. We did go into the flamingo and saw the flamingos because they had flamingos. And Mandalay Bay. I did go to Mandalay Bay, and I will tell you why in a minute. And there's another montage. Here's the Paris, and here is another Boulevard Hoover Dam. There's a postcard of the Hoover Dam. Yes, the Hoover Dam. 56. So I got this postcard to represent that, and my little journal book, and I also got this one to represent Route 66 in the little journal. Grand Canyon postcards by themselves. There's this one. Oh boy, and I got that one. This one is a whole set. And here are the postcards. There's 12 of them in this set. There's one with some lightning. Many, 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 many pictures of the watchtower. There's you. The reason, that's the watchtower. My uncle worked there. And here's another postcard. And another one. And another one. And the last one. They didn't have one of the Jaguar. Here's the Barizonia. The one of the wolf and the bear. It was funny, the bears, they had junior bears and big bears, and they said, do not stop. They made sure you did not stop in the junior bears, because the junior bears will climb on top of your car and they will pull off your mirrors. Okay, besides going to the Grand Canyon and doing the ashes, and going to Las Vegas and gamble, which by the way, gambling is very boring. Especially when you don't want you, especially when you lose the money. I kept saying, "Mom, give me $1." She's like, "I get 50% of it." I'm like, "You can have 50% of everything I lose." Yeah, gambling was very boring. Okay, besides that, I was able to go to 2 shows. And that is included in the haul. The first show I went to was with, which I think I would have cried if I didn't get to go. First show I got to go to was,
yes, Billy Idol. I know I'm a stupid. I got to go see Billy Idol.
I went to see him on October 4th. No, it was October 12th. It was October 12th. He was awesome. And I did buy, he was at the House of Blues. Here's the bag, House of Blues. I did keep the bag on this one. And I bought a t-shirt. The second show, I did not buy a t-shirt because I've seen this person so many times. But here's the t-shirt. And it was $35. Probably the most expensive souvenir of the whole. No, that's not true. Well, the one thing is not considered a souvenir. It's going to be, it's going to be what I use when I go on vacation. So I wouldn't consider it a souvenir. And second show, oh, here's the ticket. The ticket to go see Billy Idol. Was it the 12th that I went? Yep, October 12th, 2016, which was a Wednesday. The other show I went to see was Elton John. Da-da-da. And I have seen him in concert so many times. Here's his little ad for him. But when I saw his face plastered on all the billboards, he was at Caesar Palace, and that's why I went to Caesar Palace. Bailey's was across the street because when we came back to Las Vegas is when we went to see Elton John. All I had to do was walk across the street, and there he was. Billy Idol, we had to drive to Mandalay Bay. The Mirage is a little bit farther. I would have walked, but we would have had to walk back. Then we realized we could have taken the tram. But it doesn't stop at the Mirage, it stops at Bailey's, which was extremely close to Mirage. But hindsight is 20/20, you know? So, the last thing. Okay. I brought all this stuff. How was I going to get this stuff home? My carry-on was a backpack. And it was already stuffed going there because it had my camera in it. So, I wanted a carry-on bag. We were walking to Johnny Rockets, which was in Bailey's Hotel. And they had the cutest pink bag. They had two sizes, a large and a medium. And I asked the lady, is the medium too big for a carry-on? She did not know. She got out her tape measure. That was the goofiest tape measure I've ever seen. It didn't measure in inches. It measured in point feet. So, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. We figured it was about 3 inches too tall to be a carry-on. I went to eat, and then I got to thinking I could stuff everything into the bag except for the breakable mugs and my camera and put those in my backpack. So, I went ahead and got the big one. And then I got to thinking, oh, at night, why don't I go get the medium one? I know this is like foreshadowing the medium one. So I went back, and it was a different lady, and I told her that I came the night before. I got the big one. I wanted a carry-on, but that medium was too big for it, so I want to put the medium inside the big one and stuff everything in and take off. She goes, oh, we have a carry-on. It's in the corner. She didn't tell me there was a carry-on. So I got the carry-on. And she goes, oh, we have bags that slip over the carry-ons. I got that too. And she said, oh, let me show you this. I'm like, no more. She goes, we have this little purse that goes with it, and it's half price. I got that too. So let me show you what I got. So I got brand new luggage. In other words, I got the little purse, which was half price. I think it was like originally $14 and it ended up being $7. So there we go. Then I got the little bag that slips on. Here's the little bag. It slips onto the handlebar right here. And pull it over. Sorry, I got to cut right there. And you slip this over the bar and then you put the Velcro right there and it supposed to stay, but this Velcro is not very strong, which is kind of odd because This Velcro is absolutely awesome. So I don't know why this one is awesome. And this is kind of wimpy. It is what it is. And it comes with a nice... And I used this for the last day for my camera. And it worked perfectly. It worked a lot better than that yellow bag. Because the yellow bag didn't have a sturdy bottom like this one. So you can see that it has feet. And it does have the removable strap. And it's got two pockets up front. Zippy. And then there's this one and zippy. So that was, this one was about $20. Zips up. And I'll take a shot of this on top of the other bag. Here's the carry-on. It's not going to fit in the camera, but here's the carry-on. The handle comes up, of course. There's a zipper bag here. There's a zipper portion here. And then there's a zipper portion here. You can put your name here. And you can attach a bag right here on top if you need to. And this one is an expandable. What I mean by expandable is a zip it up. Ah, shit. Can you see there's two zippers? There's one zipper here. Oh, here it is. One zipper here. One zipper here. You can, let me find this zipper. You can unzip it. Go! Unzip it. And it expands another half, another inch. So it gives you a little bit extra room. Unzipping their own thing. There we go. This is so that's the carry-on size. And then there's the Big Daddy. This one is actually bigger than my original luggage. And it definitely will not fit in, as you can see. And it's pretty much set up the same way as the carry-on. And it does have the additional zipper right here that gives you another half an inch. But it's exactly the same setup. It's got a pocket here, a pocket down there. It just fell. It's got a handle here. Here to clip something on. The retractable. This, whichever it is. It's got the name badge. And it's got another zipper. And there's AJ. Hi, AJ. He's like, oh, she's talking to me now. And if anybody knows what this is right here, because I'm sure it has a purpose, please let me know. Because I don't know. Are you curious to know what I did with my old suitcase? The other one that I had, I got at Goodwill. And I only paid about $4 for it. And I got a lot of wear out of it. I got my $4 worth. But it was beginning to fall apart. Little pieces kept falling out on the bed when I tried to get some clothes. On our way to dinner for the last night, I rolled it and left it in the middle of the walkway. So a homeless person can get it because there was a lot of homeless people. And they would carry bags and stuff. And I thought they would appreciate that bag. Well, that is my hauls. And anyway, that's about it for the haul for my souvenirs. I hope you can give this a video a thumbs up if you like it. If you don't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you like what you see. And I hope you guys all have a wonderful day, evening, night, and stay calm and travel. Along.